Hello everyone, today the video is going to be on how we can create and finish two terracotta jewelry sets with minimal painting. So these are the two terracotta pieces that I'm going to be painting. Please find the link in the description box below on how I made these two pendants as well as the matching earrings. The paints that I'm going to be using are acrylic red, gold, silver and copper. I typically don't use copper that much. I can't recollect when was the last time I used it. I'm just going to be using my liner brush for this. Like I said, it's just minimal painting. I'm not going to be doing any base coat, nothing of that sort. I've laid out all of the paints, rather all the four colors in my palette, diluted it with a little bit of water. Begin with the first one, little bit of copper. Copper and this pendant is going to have a combination of copper, red and gold. The colors work very well together. In fact, copper and red is a very nice combination. Using the natural beauty, the natural color of terracotta itself as the background. You know, when I actually completed this set, I kind of asked myself as to why don't I do, more such pieces where, there's no background, just using the natural beauty of terracotta itself. In fact, I had recently someone who actually asked me that on my Instagram page. I think it was my Instagram page that, you know, why don't you, I think, have some jewelry pieces that are unpainted or with minimal painting, something like that. So anyways, yeah, so this set is done. Moving on to the next one. This particular piece is in gold and silver. So silver, again, I very rarely use silver directly in this kind of a manner. This is too bright for me. Bright in the sense, it almost looks like white. Now what I typically do is I mix it with a little bit of black to get antique silver, but in this one I have just directly used it out of the tube, just diluted with a little bit of water and painted it. It just goes well, you know, it just blends well. It's not eye hitting or it's not that bright or something, because it's very minimally used. I think the problem sometimes happens when it's just overpoweringly used with to me it just doesn't work, but yeah, I think painting, coloring, all of these are very personal preferences. So I like using just this amount of silver and nothing more than that. So in these particular carvings or grooves or, I don't know the right terminology for that, but the paint that I'm using for this particular one is again silver, just a bit diluted so that it kind of flows in and covers the entire thing. Because sometimes even though I'm using my liner brush, it doesn't really go through making sure it's all neatly done. So this way at least, things get covered easily and it just gets done beautifully. I'm using the back of my paint brush for this, and there you go, this is done. Time for varnish. So this is something which is new. I'm using a ultra matte varnish. Typically you've seen me use a satin varnish. So to give you a brief, to just differentiate, satin is somewhere in between matte and glossy. Whereas this is matte, in fact, this is ultra matte. So you see that there is like zero gloss, zero shine, which is just so appropriate. And it's something that I always prefer on terracotta, because I never used to varnish, some people prefer it with a varnish so that the paint is intact and all of that. So yeah, that's what it is. But I really like using the ultra matte, the matte or the ultra matte. I think both might actually have the same effect. Quite nice. In fact, I'll show you how it works on the earring. because I think there was a bit of a focus problem on this one. So this is the earring, and you'll see how instantly this this dries up, and it does not alter the natural color of terracotta at all. It looks lovely, it's beautiful, and doesn't change anything, and that's what I like. So don't get overwhelmed by this. I know there are a lot of things over here. So this is it's all the assembling materials that I have laid out on the beadboard. That's the gear wire, seed beads, antique brass seed beads, again something that I just picked up just randomly. I think you've seen me use that before. So these are pearl white seed beads, wooden flat beads, red, crimp beads, these are lobster clasps and jump rings. Crimp covers, earring hooks, fired terracotta beads that are also varnished using the ultra matte, my pliers. Let's begin with assembling the earrings. This is simple, you know, you've seen me use these earring hooks a couple of times. It's as simple as that. I just use my pliers and I close it. And the earrings are assembled in this manner. Moving on to the pendants. So I'll just set it up first. So these don't use nylon cords. They obviously use the gear wire. So just setting everything up in this manner. So the lobster clasp is attached to one jump ring, and then I attached two jump rings. So each pendant uses one lobster clasp and three such jump rings. There you go. They come on either sides. Let's begin assembling. So we take a piece of gear wire, put the crimp bead in, then through the jump ring, fold it again through the gear wire, press it using the crimp it using the flat nose plier, and cover the crimp bead using the crimp cover. I very carefully close it, and there you go, we begin. So I'm using a combination of these terracotta beads along with the antique brass seed beads. I'm also, so this is the assembling. So this particular set, in fact, after I completed this set, I did measure it. The outer line basically is in inches. So this actually it's 9 inches. So it's 18 inches in total. So each side is 9 inches. So this is how the entire necklace looks. Very convenient. In fact, I really like this design, and super super light, incredibly light. I was very happy with that, because this is something that I'm personally making for myself, and it's very my style. So I was happy with the outcome and the fact that it is really light and quick to wear as well. So this is how I'm assembling this particular set. Terracotta bead and the white seed bead. Just finishing this off. Just repeating the process over here. Crimp bead. I crimp it using my flat nose plier, and then I cover that with a crimp cover. And there you go. The set is also ready. Beautiful. So team it up with a lovely kalamkari sari or a crisp white shirt and a beautiful skirt, and I think it's just two really versatile terracotta jewelry sets. So simple, so elegant. Like I said, minimal amount of painting. So I really hope you all enjoyed watching this video. I am very, very happy with the outcome of both of these jewelry pieces. Please take a look at the links provided in the description box on how I made the pendants as well as the earrings. I really hope you all enjoyed watching the video. Thank you so much for watching, and thank you so much for your time.